Hey, Lexington Presbyterian Church family and friends. I wanted to give you an update about our plans for reopening over the next month or so. And those plans are always tentative. We don't know what the future holds and what the Lord will bring to us, but we wanted to lay out for you those plans that we hope will pan out in time. Before we go into the details of those plans, though, we really want to talk for a second about the most important thing in all this for us as a body of believers, as a church family. As you know, the pandemic has brought out all kinds of opinions about what is most loving to my neighbor. And there's plenty of differing opinions about that. And what we want to put forward as a church is not coming down hard on the details of one side or the other side of those things, but to really emphasize that we want to love one another. Christ will be honored if we love one another with our differing opinions. So to that end, I just wanted to review briefly with you a scripture from Romans chapter 15, verses 5 through 7, and make some comments on it by way of encouraging us to accept one another robustly with our varying opinions. Here, Romans 15, 5 through 7, it says, "May the God who gives endurance and encouragement give you the same attitude of mind toward each other that Christ Jesus had, so that with one mind and one voice you may glorify the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Accept one another then just as Christ accepted you in order to bring praise to God." So as you're watching this video, if you have descended into arguments over masks or not, or those kinds of things, I want to just encourage you to back up from those, whichever perspective you have about that. And hear this word. Paul is praying that the believers would have endurance and encouragement. I think all of us would agree that this has been a time where the persistent noise of lots of things around us has predisposed most of us to discouragement and isolation. And so the first thing that we want to say is to cry out to Jesus that he would give us endurance or perseverance to go forward as a local body of believers, and that he would encourage us in that. And then the idea is that we would have the attitude of mind that's in Christ Jesus. And again, try not to run to define in terms of the polarizations that are going on what the attitude of mind that would be in Christ would be. But to think we want to glorify the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ by being of one mind. Being of one mind doesn't mean that we all are of the same opinion about the details of the things that are going on. It means that we love one another and we want to honor Christ together with our varying perspectives on things. So Paul really summarizes the whole aspect of this by saying, accept one another just as Christ accepted you. And that's where we want to come down really strongly, is this exhortation to accept one another with our varying opinions and studies and all the things that go behind that, to love one another and to believe the best about one another, that each person is seeking to love God and love their neighbor in the way that they're formulating their plans. And then really we'll see that we bring praise to God. That's the end of that text. So I put this down. It wasn't quite that filled out, but I put this down in an email that went out. So if you didn't see that, check your junk email. And then if you're not on our mailing list, be sure to contact the church office to get on the mailing list so that you get this information. We're going to be saying things about restarting children's ministry. And if you don't get emails of information from the children's ministry, again, contact the church office so that you can be updated about the things that are going on. So we'll move on a little bit to the details now. The elders, I think, fairly were working generally with three principles as we went through this. The first principle was that we have a biblical mandate to gather for worship, including singing praises, confessing our sins, hearing the word read and preached, along with sacraments. And so that's why early on, probably 6 weeks or so ago, we restarted corporate worship. So we're doing the thing that we think is really primarily mandated already. And then that means that we could take our time with restarting some of the other things. The second principle that we were working with is, as believers voluntarily wanted to gather for fellowship and teaching, we weren't going to stand in the way of that. So if a group of people wanted to use a room, we would ask them to social distance and to clean up after themselves. We do have protocols for that, but we weren't going to say, no, you can't do that. And then the third principle was that we were going to let the school system open for a few weeks and evaluate how that was going before we formally sought to regather our children in Christian education on Sunday morning. So working with those principles, these are some of the details that we came up with. In terms of Wednesday nights, we are going to delay indefinitely having Wednesday night meals together and Kids Quest. Part of the decision about Kids Quest was that there was inadequate staffing for certain age groups. The youth are going to continue to meet on Wednesday nights, and they will eventually be breaking up into small groups. And again, they are still practicing various aspects of social distancing. There are a number of women's Bible studies and small groups that meet at various times, both on Wednesday night and other times during the week. And we are letting those restart voluntarily with instructions about preferences on social distancing, the things that we would like to see them do, as well as cleanup and disinfecting afterwards. So again, that's at the discretion of the leaders and the members of those groups, and based on the availability of the appropriate space. So that sort of covers Wednesday night. Our tentative goal for Christian education is that we would restart all of Christian education on October the 4th. And I really want to emphasize the word tentative on that right now. We are still searching for a children's ministry director. We still have volunteer spots in teaching children that are unfilled. So we don't know exactly what's going to happen as a result of the schools reopening and regathering. But that is right now our tentative goal, is to restart all of CE or Christian education at that time. And that would involve, if there are enough volunteers, restarting the nursery at 8:15 for the Christian education hour and for 11 a.m. So part of this is a call for those of you who are able and willing. You're not at high risk for having a really virulent course of COVID-19 or something, to think about volunteering in all these ways so that we could regather, teach the Bible to children, and so forth. The last thing that we are approving right now is that some of our members who have children are really eager to regather, perhaps before October the 4th. So one of our members has volunteered to step forward to have something like a one-room schoolhouse for multiple ages upstairs in the CE building before October the 4th comes. So they would try to start on August the 9th, tentatively. And if you have children, you'll be receiving email updates about that. Again, if you're not on the list, you should contact the church office to be put on that list so that you will know what's going on. In those meetings, there will not be social distancing. They'll be checking temperatures ahead of time. They'll be doing disinfecting and whatnot afterwards, taking sort of middle-of-the-road kind of precautions at that time. So that's where we're headed right now. The elders really want to reaffirm again that we are giving to each person to be informed by the Word, illuminated by the Spirit in their own conscience when they are able to come back and regather. And obviously those who are at very high risk of having a difficult course, or perhaps even fatal course of COVID-19, then, you know, continue by live stream and continue the fellowship that you can have in the ways that are really appropriate for you. In all this, what we want to say is that our mission is to give glory to God as we're making disciples of Jesus, as we worship and love and serve. And so there's nothing about our current situation that would keep us from sharing the message of Christ crucified for sinners and raised from the dead with our neighbors and friends, and inviting them to be part of this worshiping fellowship in the ways that are appropriate for them. So we want to redirect our thoughts away from all the polarizations and other things to focus on disciple making. Now, we realize, or at least I realize, that not everything that we've laid out is consistent with the principles that we've had. It assumes certain things. And I'm not going to go into all the details of that, but to come back again to sort of wrap this up, to say, let's accept one another as Christ accepted us. And let's move forward in making disciples so that we would glorify God with one mind and one voice. So thanks. I hope to see you either in person or by live stream on Sunday. Have a great day.